Huh? Who's that?
Nobody here. Who's that? HQ, please respond.
This is HQ.
Control here. Enemy sighting.
Snake, do you read? Snake!
Major.
Snake, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You're far from okay. Look at your life gauge. You're on your last leg.
No, I can still...
See?
Snake, this is a solo sneaking mission. Do you know what that means?
Yeah.
No, you don't. It means there's no backup, no cavalry. If you're taken out, nobody is there to take your place. Pull out for now and recuperate.
Find a hiding place and get some rest. Your life gauge will gradually recover with time. But the speed of your life gauge recovery depends on the level of your stamina gauge. So get plenty to eat, then get some rest. You hear me? Do you hear me?
I hear you.
Hey! Wait!
I think I saw something.
Huh?
I think I saw.
Huh?
I think I saw. I think I saw something.
Snake, do you read?
Huh? What the? Who's that? What the?
Thank you.
Who's that? HQ, please respond. Control here. Requesting backup.
Thank you. your face, I feel your sadness, I feel your pain inside of me. Why are you so afraid? How can you go on living in the past? I see your eyes, I feel your pain, I feel your sadness inside of me. Open your heart and smile. Oh,
Saving the game, Snake? Hey, Snake, have you ever seen Forbidden Planet?
No, can't say I have.
It's about this expedition that goes to the planet Altair 4 in an ultra-fast spaceship. When they arrive, they meet the survivor of the last expedition, Dr. Morbius. Dr. Morbius was exploring the planet along with his daughter Altera and the versatile Robbie the Robot. Ignoring the doctor's warnings, the expedition team is suddenly attacked by an invisible creature called the Monster from the Id. The special effects they used for the science stuff were really neat. I wish I had a robot like Robbie that could make anything I wanted it to.
I'm more interested in that invisible monster. If I were invisible, I wouldn't have to bother hiding or wearing camouflage.
Maybe someday you'll be able to turn invisible.
Yeah, that'll be the day.
I think I saw something. Huh, guess I'm... I think I saw something. I think I saw something. Guess I'm seeing. Thank you. Who was that? Nobody here.
Huh?
I think I saw something. Huh. Guess I'm seeing things. I think I saw something. Huh. Guess I'm seeing.
Who's that? Radio, we need backup. HQ, respond.
This is HQ.
Control here. Enemy sighting.
Acknowledged. Sending reinforcements.
Thank you.
I see you found a Yabloko Maloko.
Yablo what now?
Yabloko Maloko. It's a Russian name that roughly translates as milk apple. It's a type of star apple. The juice is thick and sweet, like milk, hence the name. And if you cut one in half lengthwise, you'll see a star-shaped ring radiating out from the center.
Hence the star apple.
Right. The star-shaped part has a gelatinous texture and is said to be especially tasty.
Sounds useful.
You're welcome.
For once.
Did you say something?
No, back to the mission.
Looks like you found a galova.
Galova?
Yeah, it's a fruit that's found only in that region. It's related to the jackfruit, which is commonly found in Southeast Asia.
Jackfruit, huh?
Yep, he's a cannibal.
Huh?
I didn't say anything.
No, I'm sure you...
I said, I'm sure you'd like it.
Oh.
Galova means head in Russian. It's probably called that because the fruit grows to about the size of a human head. It's supposedly pretty good to eat, with a uniquely sweet flavor. The fruit itself is fairly large, so you could make a meal out of it. Galovas grow directly off the trunk of the tree. If you're running low on stamina, it might be a good idea to keep an eye on the tree trunks.
I want some more.
untill.
I see you've captured a magpie. Magpies are members of the crow family. They're distinguishable by their beautiful dark blue and white bodies and their long tails. Their favorite food is insects, but they'll also eat small fish, acorns, and fruit. They're omnivores, which means...
they'll eat anything.
Right, just like you, huh? If you use the tranquilizer gun, you should be able to capture magpies alive.
Okay, so how do they taste?
You always ask me that.
Naturally. So?
I've never heard of anybody actually eating a magpie, but I suppose there's no reason you couldn't.
You don't say.
Thank you.
good.
I see you've caught yourself a Sunda whistling thrush. The Sunda whistling thrush is a bird native to Java and Sumatra. It's distinguished by its large blue body and long beak. It really stands out in the forest. If you're aiming to catch one alive, use the tranquilizer gun.
Got it. So...
how does it taste?
Yeah.
I don't know.
You don't know?
The guide doesn't say. I guess there's no reason you couldn't eat them.
No. I see.
But it's nice and plump, so I'm sure it'd make a hearty meal.
That's a good point.
Ugh.
Hey, this worked.
Camouflage is an indispensable...
Sokolov should be... Snake, I recommend... Snake,
eat food... Do you want to save? Snake, have you seen Earth versus the Spider?
Nope.
It's about this spider that suddenly mutates into a giant monster. They bring it into the city in a state of hibernation, but it wakes up and starts wrecking the place.
So why did the spider turn huge?
I told you, it suddenly mutated.
Yeah, right.
Snake, it's people like you that take all the fun out of watching movies. Always nitpicking and taking things too seriously. Honestly, why even bother? Look, the important thing isn't that it got big.
Then what is important?
The fact that there's a huge spider destroying the city. Suspend your disbelief. That's the whole point of movies.